United we are one, united in purpose and goal. We are a team, a strength to take into account. We are strong because we are united. We are one, and we won't be divided.
Unidad. Somos uno. Unidos en propósito y meta. Somos un equipo. Una fuerza a tener en cuenta. Somos fuertes porque estamos unidos. Somos uno y no seremos divididos.
This morning, it is my honor to introduce our keynote speaker, Mr. Brandon Ayers. Mr. Ayers is a Galax High School class of 2003 graduate. After graduation, Mr. Ayers attended Emory and Henry College on scholarship and graduated with his Bachelor of Arts degree before enrolling in law school at Liberty University. After earning his JD and being admitted to the state bar, Attorney Ayers founded his own law firm in Salem, Virginia. Last year, Mr. Ayers received a tremendous honor when he was selected to be a 2022 inductee into Virginia High School League Hall of Fame. His selection was groundbreaking because he is the very first academic inductee ever in the history of the Hall of Fame. Mr. Ayers won 4 consecutive forensic state championships, each year in a different category. He also received the Best Actor Award at the State Theater Festival 4 years in a row. Graduating high school with 8 state championships in academic competitions is a remarkable accomplishment and sets a VHSL record that remains unbroken to this day. Mr. Ayers has shared that his family comes first and is the most important thing in life to him. A firm believer in God, family, and country, Mr. Ayers is thankful to be a member of the noble profession of law, serving others, and being the change to a world that requires it.
School board members, faculty, staff, Principal Bird, Superintendent Susan Tilley, moms, dads, grandpas, grandmas, nannas, mamas, papas, friends, family, cousins, brothers, uncles, sisters, nieces, nephews, cousins, neighbors, cats and dogs of all ages, good morning. And happy graduation Saturday, Galax High School, class of 2023. Man, it is good. This is good. This feels good. It feels good to be back in front of a completely captive audience on stage at Galax High School. It's been a minute. So get comfortable. Get comfortable. Because Maroon Tide class of 2023, just think. When I conclude this speech in approximately 3 hours, you will be minutes away from the beginning of the rest of your lives. Listen, you've come a long way. You've grown so much walking those hallways up there, playing and competing out here on these fields. And all of it has led to this day. All of it has led to this moment, this place, and this time, where your preliminary training now is, it's complete, it's done. And the rest of your lives begin. So let me tell you something, and guys, look at me. This is not a funeral, it's your graduation day, so wake up and smile a little bit, all right? I know it's warm, it's okay. You only have one of these. Be alive. Be alive in these moments. And take in every single minute of it. It's fleeting, but take it in the best you can. You've earned it. Today's happiness is yours. You deserve today's happiness and the hope and the excitement of tomorrow's promises. Today is your day, okay? You've made your families proud. You've made your hometown, Galax, Virginia, you've made them proud. Am I right? You've made your alma mater proud. And today we celebrate you and the conclusion of this very special and this unforgettable chapter of your lives. Maroon Tide, job well done. All right? I applaud you. Now, I know many of you are likely wondering, naturally, and there have been many whispers about town all asking, how did the administration ever convince Brandon Ayers, the award-winning actor and playwright, author, singer, songwriter, international ambassador, learned doctor of laws and jurisprudence, 6'2" tall, handsome, and unprecedentedly talented Brandon Ayers. How did they ever get you here? Can he bestow the crumbs of his wisdom from the table of his experiences unto us, and how did that come about? Is he a world traveler? Friends asks. Yes, that's true. Friend and advisor of the rich and the famous? Yes, yes, that's true too. A man who dares to tread where few have trod and who dances like no one is watching. That is also me. The same man who won all of the awards that they make ever, period. Yes, yes, that is true. It is the same man. How could they even afford to get such a talent with such a budget? It was a Thursday afternoon, I'll tell you. It was a Thursday afternoon. I had just anchored my catamaran in a small inlet off the coast of Kukenu, Abu, in Aruba. Every Thursday of the month, I join my good friends Pete Davidson, Ashley Olson, and Mary Kate Olson to sail and to snorkel for clams, which we ultimately eat. It's a wonderful occasion. And the phone, we had just finished eating, and the phone rang, and it was Susan Tilley, and she said, "Will you be our speaker? We're prepared to offer you $850,000 and breakfast from Bojangles, if you agree." No, Susan Tilley, I cannot," I replied. Ashley Olson looked up at me, aghast that I would refuse. And then I said, I cannot accept that money, but I will accept your invitation. As long as that money is given to Principal Bird to distribute in equal shares to each and every student upon graduation." She graciously agreed. Principal, you should be clapping, folks. College is expensive. Principal Bird will have that for you after today's ceremony. If you were to happen to miss him somehow, he is available to be reached by cell phone at any time, as many times over the summer as you'd like. His cell phone number is 276-233-4611. I can't tell if that's an 8 or a 5. Anyway, see me after, and I'll get that to you. Listen, I accepted the invitation today for one reason and one reason only, and in the famous words of the great philosopher Hoobastank, the reason is you. Was that too dated? That was funny. It's fine. You see, Brandon Ayers doesn't do what Brandon Ayers does for Brandon Ayers. No, nay. You see, Brandon Ayers does what Brandon Ayers does because Brandon Ayers is Brandon Ayers. You see, that and the fact that Susan Tilley agreed that the GEHS auditorium would be remodeled and renamed the Mark Brandon Ayers Center for the Performing and the Visual Arts, which I'm thrilled about, and that will be taking place this fall. Or El Brandonito El Guapo Teatro de Artes en las Tres Antillas, for our Spanish-speaking friends. Isn't that wonderful news? You can clap. It's okay. It's okay. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. It's okay. Embrace it. I'm here. It's real. It's real. It's happening. All right. So this is how this is going to play out, guys. All right. Some ground rules first. If you're moved at any point in time into spontaneous applause, shouts, cheers of jubilation that erupt from the soul or the belly, standing ovations, that's perfectly fine. Perfectly fine. All right. It's not going to startle me. It happens a lot in everyday life. Flash photography of my person is strictly forbidden by law and will not be tolerated. However, I will be available for autographs and pictures for a nominal fee after today's program. Please take note, this is important, that toward the grand finale of today's speech, there is an audience participation part where I will ask you to start what will be the greatest slow clap of all time. All right, we're going to do that together. We're going to make it work. This is going to go down as the best speech ever with your help with that. So I'll give you a cue. I'll let you know what that is. We're going to build that slowly and continue it into intensity until there's an ultimate roar of thunderous applause at the very end. And I'll indicate by giving you this sign. So when I do this, that's when you start the slow clap, and then we just build it, right? You got it? Good. That being said, today I would like to share with you some thoughts about success. Excited? I realize that speaking about how to be successful at a high school graduation, a commencement, has never been done before. No one's ever thought of that. Certainly not cliche. It's actually the deeper meaning. It's the real definition, okay? The real definition of success that I'd like to share with you, along with some lessons that I've learned in my life that generates kind of the recipe for that very thing, okay? So I plan to start light. A few palate cleansing pointers that's good for everyday life, followed by some appetizers that pair well in both professional company and as well as casual affairs. On to my main course, and finally conclude with my three-part dessert finale, where you're going to be allowed to participate again with that gesture. You begin the slow clap, and it's going to be great. So number 10, maintain a sense of humor, okay? Laugh more. That's important to me. If you can't pick up on that, then I've already lost you. But listen, the older you're going to get, the more serious life's going to tend to be. But take time to laugh in its face. If you can't do that, that's going to be an issue. You've got to laugh. You've heard people say, well, I have to laugh because if I wouldn't, I'd cry. There's truth. There's truth in that. Smile at somebody randomly and then watch their reaction. They're going to mimic you. They're going to smile back. Without thinking, okay? Laughter releases, a sense of humor releases chemicals in the brain that correlates, okay? It correlates with trust and safety, positivity. Your brain tells you, hey, you're with good people, so you can relax and you can be comfortable. Again, guys, take some of this, take all of it, throw it all away. It's completely up to you what you do with this advice, but I'm telling you, these 10 ingredients, you knock these out, you got it. You got life. You got the bull by the horns. Number 9, be true to who you are. Be true to yourself, okay? Believe it or not, the basics and foundations of you, as it were, they're already there. Yeah, they're already there. You're going to change and you're going to grow and you're going to adapt and you're going to embrace different things, but the core of you is actually in place. It's there. You'll find as you go through life, you're going to go back to things that you were taught by your parents, by your grandparents, by those that love you, by your teachers, by those who have invested in you. You're like, oh, yeah, I remember him saying that. I should have listened the first time. There's truth in it. Go ahead and listen the first time with that. It'll save you some time and trouble and effort and energy, okay? Don't people please. You hear me? Don't try to please people. Don't try to be anything other than who you are. If someone doesn't like you, that's not your loss, okay? Don't people please. Number one, because if you do, you're always going to be asked to do it again. If you do it the first time, they're going to expect it. And number two, if you compromise you, you're going to give away a piece of a one-of-a-kind masterpiece that makes up who you are already. You're a masterpiece, believe it or not. In progress, but nonetheless. So don't do that. And remember, a need for acceptance, okay, a need for acceptance is the main ingredient of making yourself invisible to the world. The world needs leadership, it needs confidence, and confidence comes from inside of you. It comes from in you, that thing that's already there in you. You have to trust that and believe it. You're here today. It's time. Stand true to yourself. It makes you untouchable, okay? It makes you the envy of every party you'll go to, every social event you'll attend, the interview, the job position, every scenario that there can be, because it can't be replicated by virtue of the fact that there is and there only ever will be one you, all right? Number 8. Know the power of silence. I've not mastered this one, personally. The loudest noise recorded on Earth is that of complete silence, all right? If you don't know what to say, or if any contribution to a situation you can't readily determine in that moment, word to the wise, just wait. You don't always have to have an answer on the spot, believe it or not, you don't. Especially when you don't have one. That'll get you in trouble. Rob Carpenter was a principal at Galax High School. I understand he's passed away, so I can't get detention. He can't do anything, right? Is Rob still around? He's passed. Rob Carpenter was straight out of central casting as far as principals go, in my opinion, at least from my high school perspective. He seemed to be always serious. I know this wasn't a reflection of him as a total, as a whole, but I remember I got called into the principal's office. I had sprayed another student with a fire extinguisher. Bad. It was not good. I didn't mean to, but that wasn't believable either. So I'm in Rob Carpenter's office, and he looks at me, and he's saying all of the,
Mr. Ayers, I need to know if you're actually, this is actually very serious. Do you not take this, Mr. Ayers?
And I'm just, yes, oh yeah, I know it. Just shouldn't spray people. Shouldn't do that. Should not do that. And then I said something, I can't remember what it was. He leaned forward, and he looked at me,
excuse me, Mr. Ayers. Are you questioning my veracity?
I had no idea what that meant. I didn't know that word. I didn't know what it meant. So I wanted to sound as confident. So I said, well, respectfully, sir, yes, yes, sir. Yes, I'm questioning your that thing you said. That was the wrong response. I got 3 days in school suspension. If you don't know what to say, it's okay to be quiet. Silence is powerful. Use it when you can. Number seven, practice humility, all right? At all times with all people. Humility is actually, humility, believe this or not, is one of my finest strengths. And I tell people that everywhere I go. But really, if you can master this, life's going to reward you for it. Even if you can get the ballpark, you're gonna be a lot better off. Contrary, look, to what you see today with me, real humility comes out of an appreciation. All right, guys, this is important. It comes out of an appreciation for other people, an understanding that your situation and their situation, while sometimes seemingly worlds apart, it's a shoe that could just as easily fit on your foot as it does theirs. Just a matter of grace between you and that situation. So remember that, okay? All right, practice humility at all times with all people. Number six, surround yourself. Surround yourself with people that are better than you are. I'll be honest. My friends started applying to college when I was in high school, because that's how it works. But there was a bulletin board outside, I don't know if they still do this, outside the guidance office, and every time one of my friends got into college, they would put a star with their name on it under that college name. And I'd never thought that far. It's not that I didn't have encouragement or my parents weren't saying it. I just, you know, that just wasn't me at the time. But it bothered me that I wasn't on that wall. I never saw myself going to college. I'm a poor kid from small cotton town, Freeze, Virginia. I mean, who am I going to go to college? College Brandon? No. But it bothered me enough that I wanted to get my name on that board, so I started applying. It was because of the people that I was hanging out with that was applying that encouraged me to do that. Believe it or not, when I got to college, the same problem still haunted me. I thought, hey, I've got a bachelor's degree, so I'm going to go out and make $100 million a year, and everything will be okay with a bachelor's, and that's great. My friends were starting to apply to graduate programs, and I had to ask myself, okay, Brandon, really, what do you want in life? And then what quality do you want to have? What do you want to achieve? Are you done? Do you want to go ahead and start? Do you want to take it further? So I started applying. I wanted to act and do a bunch of things. God in his good graces saw that there was a marriage between what I actually do now and what I fell into, because I went to law school as a plan B. I remember my first day of law school, I showed up in class and I looked around me and I realized in 2 seconds, I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm the only plan B in a room full of plan A's. I'm married to this now. But still, managed to make it work, and that was only because I surrounded myself with people that were different than I was. Believe this or not, my first two rap albums, the first two rap albums I released were horrible, and it's hard for me to admit that today, but I'm doing it in front of you on record, okay? My rap albums were not great, all right? Grossed a little over $480 million, but no more than that. But that's not kept me from being in the studio each and every single time that my friend Nicki Minaj is in the studio, and I'm able to make it there with her to study to her. Actually, two weekends ago, I chartered a flight to Reno, Nevada, to her studio, and I feel I finally made some progress in my rapping skill. Listen, I can show you. I told you I'd show you what I mean. Nikki said, at this rate, I'm very likely to appear on her next album, Hot White Chocolate Brandonito. Look out for it. Number five. You still with me? Still there? It's a happy day, it's a hot day, but it's the only day like it, so let's enjoy it, okay? Let's keep going. Number five, be alive while you are living. Did you miss that? Be alive while you're living. Okay, my entire family, my ancestors have suffered from a mortal disease called dead. In fact, all of my relatives that I'm aware of ultimately have died from death in the end. I have a feeling that I probably will succumb to the same fate. It runs in our family, I'm sure it does in many of yours, but life really truly is no dress rehearsal. You're here once, guys, you're here one time. You have one today, you have one tomorrow, one the day after. You graduate high school once, you're gonna sit here once, you're gonna be this hot, but only this hot once. Embrace it, okay? We all have an appointment with the hands of time. So while you are alive, be alive, take chances. Taste the rain, climb the mountain, embrace the unknown, love even with a broken heart. And remember, you can fail at doing what you don't want to do, so you might as well take a chance at failing at doing what you love, you know? Personally, I refuse to believe in failure, no matter how many times I fail. In 2020, just before the pandemic outbreak, I was out on vacation with Bruno Mars and his terrific family in Cabo. And Bruno Mars, terrific, fantastic guy, just the coolest guy ever. I love him. After a long day on the beach, we decided to go to dinner at Café de Longerin. It's a very fancy place. And we were waiting for our limo driver. While we were waiting, there was actually a horrible accident in front of our hotel in the street outside of the compound involving a taxi driver and a couple nuns and a transport vehicle that was taking apparently 37 Spanish seals to a Spanish seal sanctuary. It was horrible, and the smell was uptown funk. That wasn't written down. That just came to me. Bruno's family decided to order out, so he and I really weren't ready to call it a day. Admittedly, we took to the town on foot and had ourselves a dinner, a few drinks, and found ourselves at Paco Romero's family cliff diving experience overlooking El Mendito Beach. The native translation of that area, of course, is sands of the spilt milk of the goat. Did you hear me? Sands of the spilt milk of the goat. That's never been said here, I promise. Bruno is a prankster. Bruno Mars is a jokester, and he dared me to sample the goat milk and jump from the cliff face into the water below. I did it. I broke 843 bones that evening. I'm told that there's not that many bones in a human body by medical professionals. I got a tattoo of Roy Orbison that night, too, in a location I will not disclose at this time. But with the taste of goat milk on my breath, I was ecstatic, I was falling, I was truly alive in that moment. I'm not recommending that you get a tattoo like that, and I'm not recommending that you drink goat milk with Bruno Mars and jump off of cliffs, all right? But the message is this, you know, be alive while you're living, okay? Take some chances, take some risks, be responsible, but don't be afraid. Never, ever, ever be afraid. The most popular book in the entire world mentions that more than anything else. The Bible, it says, never, don't be afraid. Number four, I'm winding down. Still there, everybody? Ask for help. It's one of the best tools in your arsenal. It makes old people feel like they're relevant again, so that's good. And it actually gives you a benefit. It's usually a free one. It's usually valuable advice. It allows your humility that I talked about before, it allows that to shine through. And most people really wish, in looking back, that they had asked for help. I know that I wish that I had at times. In 1994, I got a phone call from Playtone Productions on behalf of an actor, a young actor named Tom Hanks. You've probably never heard of him. I call him T. Hank for short because of an inside joke we have, but I won't get into that. He was filming a picture called Forrest Gump at the time. And I was 9 years old and attending Galax Middle School, and his acting coach said that T. Hank was struggling with his character and wanted to know if I could fly down to Savannah to help him. And I said, sure, I'll be there. So my mom got me a plane ticket, and I went down. And I was sitting with T. Hank, and he said, Brandon, I don't know how to do this character, Forrest Gump. And he was going to go with a Boston accent. I think it was like, life is like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're going to get. I was running, et cetera. And I was like, no, Tom, listen, why don't you take a more southern approach to it? Slow it down. You know, chocolates, I was running, that kind of thing. Tom was thrilled after we met. I went to the movie premiere, and I was fourth row from the front, and I'll never forget, he looked over his shoulder and winked at me, and I knew that he knew that I knew that he knew that meeting was worth it, but he asked for help. And that that story that I just told you is 100% true that I just made up. Moral of the story is that successful people never shy away from asking for help, okay? It's enduring. It makes you approachable. It makes people remember you, and it makes them feel like they're helping you. And they invest in you, and that actually makes them interested in you. Don't be afraid to ask anybody for help. It's okay. You'll be better for it. All right. Now, final three. Now for the dessert. So warm up those slow clapping hands. We're getting ready to take this baby home, all right? I've given you seven pointers that I truly believe make up somebody that's gonna be successful, that you need to be successful. These last three are critical, guys. So at this point, all jokes aside, if nothing else, if you listen to these three things I'm about to tell you, if you don't listen to anything else, I promise you, you'll be poised in position for all the success that this side of the river can afford you. Okay, you ready to pull it home? Well, clap or something. Come on, guys, it's graduation day. I told you that. Do I got to remind you again, right? This is your day. The definition of success, guys, listen. Successful people, if you disagree with this, you need to listen closer. Listen, the definition of success, it's not about your accomplishments. It's not about your money. It's not about your trophies. It's not about your awards. It's not about your jobs. True success is measured. Listen, do you want to be successful? Listen to these next three things, especially this. You want to be successful? It's about what you do for other people. Success, a successful person lives their life for other people, not themselves first. And listen, it's this weird thing, but it works that way. It comes back to you. Number three, of two and one. Three, always be respectful. On first glance, that sounds like something you heard every day of your life, right? But you live in a new time. You live in a new age today, where there's a new movement or pronoun or policy or something that is different than it was the day before, and you have to take that into account in your everyday comings and goings. How you conduct yourself and how you treat other people matters so much. The butterfly effect is not just a book, and it's not just a theory. If you don't know what I'm talking about, read up on it. It's a real thing. What you put out goes out and stays out forever. The political climate is drastically different than it was, when all of us were growing up. And it'll continue to get different as you grow up and your kids and your children's children. But listen to me, no matter how the world evolves, no matter the issue, the policy, the individual claim, always be respectful to others, especially those who hold different beliefs than your own. In fact, you need to study them most. Get to know them best. They're the ones that can teach you, mold you, sharpen your iron. Your knowledge will expand, your appreciation for the struggle that other people go through will grow, and your convictions are either going to be challenged, changed, solidified, or all of the above. I don't want to make, and listen, I am not making this political at this point. I'm not. I've always told no politics and no religion at the supper table. Well, we're not having supper. So just take this for what it's worth. I wouldn't be doing my job today if I didn't talk about the elephant or the donkey in the room. See what I did there? But when politics turn on party lines and divisive policy affects you personally, things that you disagree with, let me encourage you to do this. Listen first, react second, and then ultimately speak third. When you hear politicians saying, we need to make America great again, I can tell you something today. Your America, this America today, is great. In fact, it's the greatest country on earth. It always has been, it is today, and it's gonna be tomorrow. And you're sitting in its arms as its future. I know this is true. That America doesn't need to be made great. America is great, and I know it because I'm looking at America right now and the future of it, every one of your faces. This is what I mean. I don't know if you heard it when the principal said so. 55% of you earned advanced studies diplomas. 8 earned by literacy seal, 3 graduated from governor's school, 15 early college students this semester earning 214 college credits, 3 students already graduated with their associate's degree, 70% GPA 3.0 or higher, 52%, 3.5 or higher, 35%, 4.0 or higher. These are private school numbers, Galax City Public Schools. What have you done? And one will serve our country in the military. I bet his name is Mr. Mason Smith, right? Mason Smith, where are you at today, buddy? Mason Smith, stand up, if you don't mind. This is how I can tell you America still is great. Mason, your town thanks you. I appreciate your service, what you're going to do for the country, your sacrifice for us. We appreciate you, brother. God bless you, man. Give him a round of applause, guys. The world needs you. This freedom we take for granted comes at the expense of people like Mr. Mason, who chooses to make personal sacrifices so that some of us can go off to trade school or to college or to pursue our dreams or go into the family business. When the media doubts your future, you look inside yourself and realize that everything I've talked about today is here and it's alive inside you already right now. America is great if you choose to be great, and you already are, so do it. Engage in those things you disagree with. Always know, though, that showing the person respect is the most important thing. It's your dignity, all right? It's your dignity. Always show everyone, you don't have to agree with them, but show them the respect of listening, right? Engage them, and then hug their neck after you disagree, and then you're an American still, right? Number two, never quit. Set your mind to your goals and let nothing stand in your way. I told you law school was a plan B for me. I've never said this publicly, and Evan Hank is sitting here listening to this, and I'm really biting my tongue. I don't know whether he works for the Commonwealth Attorney's Office, and I'm in court with him once in a while, but I'm going to say it. I'm going to say it. I took the bar exam the first time, and I failed it. So I took it again, and I failed it. I took it the third time. And let me tell you what, guys, I'm not used to that. I don't like people to know. I was embarrassed. I went into a depression even, sort of. I didn't like that. But you know what? You got to fail. So go fail big. It told me that, you know what? I know if I can't say anything else, if I was still trying to pass the bar exam after 8 to 9 years, I would still be taking that test, because you know what? I refuse to let anybody or anything say, Brandon, you can't. I say, yes, I can do it. You know the difference between the man who said, I can do it, and the man who said, I can't? You know the difference, or actually the common thing that they have? Is that they're both right. If you say, I can't do it, then you're right. You can't. If you say you can do it, absolutely you can, and you will. All right, guys. So we're here. End of my long speech. I told you it'd be 3 hours. Oh, really? And now you're going to clap? Great. All right. Fair enough. Listen to what I'm about to say above all, and go ahead and get ready for this slow clap buildup, because the more you do it, the bigger it gets and the quicker this ends. Guys, if I could share one thing with you, and I do want to say, I've joked about a lot of things. I'm so honored. I'm so humbled. I cannot thank you all for this distinction in the adequate words. I simply can't. You're going to be fellow alums with me here in just a few moments. Parents, you're going to have to cut some strings, as hard as that might be. But trust them. You got them to this point. And I'm looking at their faces. They're going to be fine. This is our future, and it looks good. Okay? You got a lot to be proud of. But if you can listen to one thing, I told you there was three, this is the main one. This, by the way, does not reflect the opinion of Galax City Schools, school board, or anything like that. This is coming from me. So, sorry, not sorry, if I could leave you with one final thing, and that would be this. Keep God first. Keep God first in every single thing that you do, and every single way that you go, where you go, what you do, how you do it. Keep God first. Now, if this is a foreign concept and I've offended you at this point, I'm sorry, but again, not sorry. But let me tell you, the successful person knows that everybody has a boss. Even those that will go into business for themselves and they're their own boss, you still have a boss. If you're a guy, it's your wife. If you're a girl, it's going to be God, and then not your husband. But really, You have to have something bigger than you to guide you, to believe in. You know why? Because it requires faith. And you have to have faith not just in the God that you believe in, but faith in humanity, faith in tomorrow, faith in yourself, faith in the world to change it. You have to have it. Where does faith come from? Primarily from God first. So do that. Rely on him. And do you know what? What's kind of funny is that all of the things I've talked about, if you just do this one thing, they fall right underneath it really easy. They do. You're going to fail time and time again, and that's okay, and you should embrace it. But it's the strength you take from that. It's the strength that you take from God that will allow you to overcome anything, accomplish everything, and be to other people the person that you want them to be to you. Know the true definition of success in your life, and you're going to accomplish it. All right. So you ready? Slow. Build it. Galax High School. Class of 2023. Remember these words. If you want to change the world, keep building it. Feels good. You can. If you want to be the difference, you will. If you're excited beyond measure about what the future holds for you, you're not clapping, young man. Start clapping your hands. You and all of us are counting on you. Mind these words. Keep your sense of humor. Be true to yourself and who you are. Know the power of silence, when to use it. Practice humility at all times. Now let's bring it home. With all people, surround yourself with those that are better than you. Ask for help. Be alive while you're living. Show respect. Never give up. And keep God first. Galax High School, class of 2023. It's an honor. God bless you. Good luck to you. And I hope that your future is great. Just as great as you are. God bless.
Good afternoon, teachers, families, friends, and most importantly, class of 2023. I would like to begin by thanking the teachers that shaped us, the parents that raised us, and our friends that were the glue simply holding everything together. All we've ever wanted to do is to grow up. For a lot of us, we've grown up sharing endless laughter and inside jokes within the walls of our classroom since 2010. We yearn to be older, taller, wiser, and stronger. The girls would laugh about being taller than all the boys in middle school, only to come back from summer break a few years later, having to look up to meet their eyes. We grew up anxiously waiting for the bell to ring at the beginning and end of each day. We grew up reading picture books, and somewhere along the line, we moved on to chapter books. Now here we are, closing one chapter of our lives and turning the page to a new one. I'm so grateful I was able to be your class president for the last 4 years. I know we have constantly heard how great our class is from administrators and teachers, but it's true. We've set the example for the classes behind us, whether that's been through how we walk through the hallways, how we act in school assemblies, or how we respect those around us. As we move on to this next chapter, I encourage each of you to stay true to yourselves. Treat others with respect and kindness. You never know what someone is going through or how you can impact his or her life. Your words and how you treat people reflect who you are as a person. Choose to be the example of kindness and compassion that you wish for others to become. While after this day, most of us will grow apart, that doesn't change the fact that for a long time we grew side by side. We cheered as Mr. Stewart got pied in the face at field day. We sang Firework by Katy Perry in front of our parents and teachers. We laughed and cried as we watched our fourth grade end of the year slideshow, anxious and excited to enter middle school. We bragged about how long we could jump rope in Ms. Houck's gym class. We ate Mr. Stewart's hot dogs and hamburgers at Cumberland Knob for the first, but not the last time. We rushed to Mr. Romer's classroom to get a turn playing Super Smash Bros. We entered the halls of high school in eighth grade, surrounded by students twice our size. We cheered and screamed during the pep rallies, just so we could beat the upperclassmen and win the spirit stick. We dressed up in crazy outfits to scream on the bleachers at football games. We blinked, and now we're here. What we didn't realize about growing up was how fast time would fly by. Years of waiting for this moment turned into months. Months turned into weeks. Weeks turned into days. Days that have now come to an end. What I do know is that endings are inevitable. High school wasn't meant to last forever, and it's time to say goodbye. But goodbyes can be sad, so I'd rather say hello. Hello to a new adventure, beginning, and future. As we move on in life, may we never forget what shaped us to be the young and bright individuals that we have become. And even though we grew up full of dreams and disappointments, difficulties and successes, tears and laughter, we know we still have growing to do. So class of 2023, may we never stop growing up.
Good morning, class of 2023. We finally did it. After 13 long and hard years, we are finally at the last chapter of high school. For the most part, these are the faces that I have known and grown up with for the entirety of my life, and I couldn't be more proud to have gone through those 13 years with you all. I'd like to thank all of my teachers, from Ms. Robinson in kindergarten to Dr. Saul this final year, for encouraging me to learn and be successful from the very beginning. I also want to thank my parents for teaching me the importance of hard work and grit, but also compassion and patience. Looking back, something that I constantly heard from myself, my friends, and my classmates was just one more. That usually meant just one more class, one more hour, one more day until the weekend, one more day until we were free to be on our own instead of being in class. Now what I've heard is just one more day. Because while graduating high school is a huge accomplishment, it's also terrifying. There are some of you here that I might not see again for the rest of my life, and that change is scary. However, I have no doubt that if anyone can go out and face the unknown, it's our class. We will start a new chapter of our lives, and there will be ups and downs, failures and successes, new relationships and old ones, but I know that we will face the unknown with courage and determination. I know we have a tendency to act older than our age, because in reality, 17 or 18 years old is still so young, and seeming childish is our worst nightmare. But now that the world is the one considering us adults instead of ourselves,
I would give anything to be a little kid again, playing on the elementary school playground without a care in the world. So let's go out into the world with a piece of that childhood always kept close. Not taking things so seriously and finding a way to make a bad situation into something good and fun are things that are just as important now as they were 13 years ago. So enjoy each day and this next chapter of your life, because look at how far we've come in just a short 18 years. Who knows what's in store for the rest? Thank you. Good morning, faculty and staff, family and friends, and fellow graduates. I'd first like to thank the people who helped us get to this moment. Teachers who became our mentors, parents who raised us to be the successful graduates we are, and friends who made the journey worthwhile. Although graduation is a momentous occasion, it always seemed to be so far away. From our freshman year to even just a month ago, it was an event that people only talked about, not a reality. And even now, as I stand here looking out at the faces I have grown up with, this moment is still surreal. My 13 years at Galax have taught me many things: reading, algebra, chemistry. But perhaps the most important lesson I have learned is that there is always room to grow. Whether it's academically or personally, growth is the only way to move forward in life. Each of us has grown as individuals over the years, but we have also grown as a class. We grew when we learned that shooting silly bands at each other would get them banned in elementary school, and we learned that we still had growing to do when the same thing happened with fidget spinners in middle school. We grew when spring formals became prom and gym class became varsity sports. And we have grown maybe the most a high schooler can by walking across this stage. After today, we are no longer high schoolers. We will be young adults who are ready to make their impact on the world. JHS has been our teacher for this chapter of our lives, and now we must use the knowledge we have been taught to do some good in this world. I know we will be successful in our endeavors because I know who we, the class of 2023, are. We are leaders, hard workers, athletes, artists, musicians, innovators, and members of the Maroon Tide Nation. Galax has given us the opportunity and the tools to go to college, the workforce, or any future that we want. Now it is up to us to use the foundation we have been given and continue to grow. Thank you.
Row one, please rise. Jeremias Ernesto Acosta Pacheco. Meshka Alaeldin Ali. Kayla Renee Archer. William Daniel Austin. Angelina Janae Avila Gaitan. Haley Alexa Baker. Brian Galvan Banda. Colton Gray Barnes. Jose Enrique Barrios Lopez. Row two, please rise. Isaac James Bartlett. Tierra Sky Bedwell. Jeremiah Matthew Blevins. Xavier Ray Blevins. Bradley Connor Bolin. Havana Yost Carter. Kale Thomas Carter. Trenton Adam Church. Riley Sky Koch. Mason Charles Cox. Row three, please rise. Emily Erin Diggs. Nubia Vianney Echeverria. David Alberto Espinosa Guzmán. Makaitan Salvador González. Lacey Isabella Graham. Keely Elizabeth Gray. Takesha Yvette Hampton. Julian Ryan Hanks. Simon Alexander Hanks. Juliana Michelle Hernandez Munoz. Row 4, please rise. Karen Berenice Hernandez Urbina. Claire Joins Huff. Hallie Gardner Huff. Uli Alejandra Ibarra. Katrina Grace Iroller. Grace Ann Justice. Evan Gregory King. Kylie Jade Lawrence. Carissa Jade Limeberry. Mia Kathleen Yamas. Row 5, please rise. Eva Graciana López. Haley María Mazariegos Pérez. Malachi Christopher Ryan McCulloch. Zachariah Gage McGuire. Casey Lane McPherson. Jenny Joanna Medina Mazariegos. Gerardo Mejia Montejano. Cynthia Arabelli Mendoza Ramirez. Daniel Menendez. Michaela Lynn Miller. Row 6, please rise. Jalen Elise Moraski. Nayeli Munoz Rosales. Ali Melina Owin. Yaneli Yacalin Pineda López. Asani Monique Poindexter. Jeffrey Samir Ramirez Garcia. Stephanie Ramirez Perez. Raina Jade Robbins. Carissa Gail Robinson. Perla Yasmin Rodriguez Rodriguez. Row 7, please rise. Rosalba Rosales Moreno. Emma Elizabeth Roten. John Kyle Roop. Jetta Lene Sawyers. Mason Dean Smith. Angel Soto Soto. Jason Tyler Stewart. Carly Ray Sturgill. Carly Nicole Todd. Kaden Yareli Turcios Colindres. Row 8, please rise. Kevin Landon Turner. Hayden Levi Utt. Carlos Jared Varela Erazo. Riley Joe Vaught. Diana Catherine White. Caden Nicholas Young.
Graduates, please rise. By the power vested in me by the Galax City School Board and the Commonwealth of Virginia, I now pronounce you graduates of Galax High School with all the rights and privileges therein. You may turn your tassels. I present to you the graduates of Galax High School for the 2023 school year. Congratulations.